राइट फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू न्यूज़ एट ए ग्लांस फॉर 19th वीक फ्रॉम 9th मे टू 15th मे। फर्स्ट पॉइंट, अमेज़न हैज लॉन्च्ड एन ऑनलाइन वीडियो सर्विस टू राइवल गूगल्स यूट्यूब। ऑल ऑफ यू आर फैमिलियर विद यूट्यूब वीडियोस एंड सिमिलरली ऑनलाइन वीडियो सर्विस दैट इज अमेज़न वीडियो डायरेक्ट वॉज लॉन्च्ड बाय अमेज़न and it will allow users to post videos and earn royalties. Look into the next one. 1 crore people in Tamil Nadu have taken ethical voting pledge. Basically, the purpose is to stop people from accepting money to vote. This is the initiative of Election Commission, and at the same time, please don't forget, Election Commission is the constitutional body established on 25th January 1950. Look into the next one. In e-agriculture category, agriculture project of Andhra Pradesh, that is Harita Priya, has won the prestigious World Summit on the Information Society Prize 2016. This WSIS forum gave this prize, and Andhra Pradesh project, that is Harita Priya. You may ask, what is Harita Priya? That is harmonized information of agriculture, revenue and irrigation for a transformation agenda. So this project basically to collect specific climate data from farms and give farmers personalized information through SMS. Please look into this slide. The farmer got message through SMS. Look into the next one. National Statistical Commission. New chairperson is Radha Binod Barman. And this National Statistical Commission was set up based on the recommendations of C. Rangarajan Committee. And in all statistical matters, this is advisory body. So, if someone talks about the National Statistical Commission, Radha Binod Barman took over as new chairperson. That is one aspect. And it is advisory body on all statistical matters. And look into the next news, that is NASSCOM and Facebook. All of you are familiar with NASSCOM. NASSCOM is a trade body of software sector, software and BPO. And Facebook is a social network giant. These two came together. Basically, they signed a memorandum of understanding to build a product design initiative for Indian entrepreneurs. And Facebook will support over 500 product startups on product design. Look into the next one. For the startups, government is doing a lot for developing the startup ecosystem in the country, and for the startups, Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, that is DIPP under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, started issuing Unique Business Identification Number or UBIN. Basically, these budding entrepreneurs will be connected to the Ministry of Corporate Affairs through this Unique Business Identification Number, so that they can set up their businesses without any delay. So this facilitates budding entrepreneurs. Look into the next one. All of you are familiar with Shashi Kapoor, who acted in around 160 films, which include 12 English films. Shashi Kapoor, the householder, the star. This is the biography of Shashi Kapoor, was authored by film journalist Asim Chhabra with the foreword by Karan Johar, and this was released recently. And if you talk about Shashi Kapoor, he got Padma Bhushan in 2011 and Dada Saheb Phalke Award he got in 2014. World Migratory Bird Day was observed on May 10, 2016. This was initiated in 2006. Basically, there is a need for the conservation of migratory birds and their habitats. And if you look at the theme for 2016, the theme is Stop the Illegal Killing, Taking and Trade of Migratory Birds. Look into the next one. World's first holographic flexible smartphone was developed by the scientists from Queen's University of Canada. This is named HoloFlex, and basically it has got a OLED touchscreen display. What is meant by OLED? This is a flexible organic light emitting diode, and without any headgear or special glasses, you can view 3D images. That is the beauty of this holographic flexible smartphone. And you may have a doubt, what is meant by holography? Holography is a photographic recording of a light field. Here the light field is recorded, that is photographic recording of a light field, but not an image formed by a lens, right? And if you want more about it in the following weeks, please listen to SNT module. Subsequent to the order issued by the Supreme Court of banning diesel taxis in National Capital Region, all of you are well aware, Supreme Court banned diesel taxis in the National Capital Region. Subsequently, to look at the situation arising out of this directive by the Supreme Court, Union Government constituted a 3-member committee headed by Sanjay Mitra, Secretary, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Sea Harriers, these are the fighter planes. You are looking into the picture. Please look into this. This is a Sea Harrier. These are the fighter planes developed by British in 1960s. And they are also known as the White Tigers. First time they were introduced in Goa in 1983. And now they were decommissioned by Indian Navy at a function organized at Osco, Goa. Now Sea Harriers were decommissioned by Indian Navy. Look into the next one. Harish Rawat won the floor test in Uttarakhand. And President's rule was revoked and he became the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand once again. And about Article 356, we recently discussed in detail in the news analysis. Please listen to it. Here we are looking at 4 personalities, that is Ajay Manikrao Kanvilkar, Chief Justice of Madhya Pradesh High Court, then D.Y. Chandrachud, the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court, Ashok Bhushan, Chief Justice of Kerala High Court, Lav Nageshwar Rao, Senior Advocate. The above 4 personalities, or you can say above 4 persons, have been appointed as the Supreme Court judges by the Supreme Court Collegium. And don't forget, the maximum strength in Supreme Court is 31, and President signs the warrants for appointment under Article 124(2). And these are the first appointments to Supreme Court after National Judicial Appointments Commission was struck down in October 2015. Look into the next one. Uttar Pradesh government decided to develop a bicycle highway from Taj Mahal in Agra. All of you are familiar with the Taj Mahal in Agra to Lion Safari, Etawah, over a length of 197 kilometers. So, Uttar Pradesh government decided to develop a bicycle highway from Agra to Etawah over a length of 197 kilometers. Look into the next one. Government decided to go slow on hydroelectric projects in Tawang. There is a resistance from local people. Government of India considered this because Tawang is the border town. It is situated near India-China border in Arunachal Pradesh. And decision will be taken after discussion with the local people. And please look into this. This Tawang is situated in Arunachal Pradesh, close to China. And at the same time, I would like to tell you one more point. Arunachal Pradesh is claimed by China. Under these circumstances, local people will be involved before taking any decision about hydroelectric projects in Tawang. And if you want more about Tawang, 2 rivers are there, Tawang Chu, Nyamjang Chu. These 2 are near Tawang. Then religious festivals, Losar and Torgya, these are also celebrated in Tawang. And at the same time, famous tribe of Tawang is Monpa, M-O-N-P-A, Monpa tribe. If someone asks about Monpa tribe, that is the Tawang region of Arunachal Pradesh. Reliance Jio has launched a digital wallet app service, Jio Money, to common people. And Reliance has partnered with over 50,000 merchants to enable transactions for purchases. And Reliance Jio, big launch of mobile phones, is awaited shortly. And look into the next one. Lonely Planet. All of you are familiar with this Lonely Planet. That is the largest travel guidebook publisher in the world and published in Melbourne in Australia. And it released the list of awardees, that is the best Indian destination for wildlife award, was won by Madhya Pradesh Tourism. Madhya Pradesh is home to Bandhavgarh, Kanha and Pench. And at the same time, don't forget, Kerala is the best family destination. Look into the next one. Reserve Bank of India, which is the regulator for banking sector in India, recently announced that it will issue banknotes of rupees 1000 denominations with the inset letter R in both the number panels. And all the other security features of Mahatma Gandhi series of 2005, like ascending size of numbers, bleed lines and enlarged identification marks, they will continue. And additional feature will be inset letter R in both the number panels. Look into the next one. All of you are familiar with the CGPDTM. CGPDTM is the Controller General of Patents, Designs and Trademarks. It is under Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, Ministry of Commerce and Industry. It is the nodal authority for intellectual property in our country. Intellectual property basically involves patents, copyrights, trademarks, and CGPDTM looks at these aspects. And it recently granted American pharmaceutical company Gilead Sciences the patent for hepatitis C drug, that is sofosbuvir, in India. Right, if someone asks about the nodal authority for granting this intellectual property rights in our country, one should not forget CGPDTM. Indian Railways abolished its dual freight policy for carrying iron ore. Previously, Indian Railways has got such a price structure when the iron ore is meant for exports, charges are different. When the iron ore is meant for consumption in India, charges are different. So that dual freight policy now abandoned by Indian Railways. It was criticized previously in several quarters, don't forget. You are looking at carrots, and scientists recently unveiled the gene, that is a sequencing of genomes was done for carrots. And it was given name DCAR032551. And at the same time, please don't forget, already genome sequencing was completed for potato, cucumber, tomato, pepper. And now carrot joined the other vegetables for which genome sequencing was completed. Right? And this DCAR032551. It gives rise to carotenoids, a rich source of vitamin A. Carrots is a rich source of vitamin A, all of you are familiar with. Australian scientists have unearthed a fragment of the world's oldest known ground edge axe. And it is estimated to be around 49,000 years old. 3-day International Vichar Mahakumbh was held in Ujjain, Madhya Pradesh. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena have released a Simhastha Declaration, and it has got 51 sacred points for betterment of mankind. Look into the next one. You are looking at logos NTPC and Coal India Limited. These two are public sector giants in the country. NTPC is into power generation, thermal power generation. Coal India Limited is into extraction of coal, and these two came together and formed a joint venture agreement for reviving the closed NAFTA-based Gorakhpur and Sindri units. And this joint venture is expected to induct strategic partner in future, and the revised units will use gas as raw material to make a total of 1.27 million tons of urea. And now the defunct urea units of Gorakhpur and Sindri will be revised. Look into the world's largest cargo aircraft. Please look into this picture. This is the world's largest cargo aircraft, and its name is Antonov An-225 Mriya, and it was manufactured by Antonov. Antonov belongs to Ukraine, and it is the world's largest cargo aircraft, which landed at Hyderabad International Airport for refueling, and it was carrying a cargo of 117 tons of Czechoslovakia manufactured turbo generator to Perth in Australia. And at the same time, please don't forget Antonov of Ukraine and Reliance Defense, headed by Anil Dhirubhai Ambani, submitted a proposal for creating passengers regional aircraft. Look into the next one. Prakash Singh Committee submitted its report on Jat agitation, and it identified 90 officials who indulged in deliberate negligence. The Supreme Court extended the ban on registration of new diesel vehicles with an engine capacity of 2000 cc and above in Delhi and NCR till further notice. India is fighting a case with the United States of America at World Trade Organization with regard to procurement of solar cells and modules under a domestic content requirement. This United States of America contested India's decision to go for this domestic content requirement for procurement of solar cells and modules. And the case is going on with the World Trade Organization between India and United States of America. We have deliberated in detail about this previously in various lectures. India's annual core sector growth reduced to a decade low of 2.7% in 2015-16. Please don't forget there are 8 core industries, and core sector growth reduced to decade low of 2.7% in 2015-16, and it puts a question mark over the figures of GDP growth, which is hovering around 7.5%. Look into the last one. It is reported by Bangladesh investigation team that Bangladesh's central bank became more vulnerable to hacking when SWIFT became the transaction system. All of you are familiar with SWIFT. What is SWIFT? That is Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. That is the communication channel for interbank operations across the world. And in Bangladesh's central bank, 3 months prior to that, this SWIFT became operational. Now the suspicion is this hacking took place after this SWIFT became the bank transaction system in Bangladesh. All of you are familiar with $81 million cyber heist of Bangladesh Central Bank, which took place recently. And at the same time, please don't forget SWIFT means Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. Right friends, with this let us conclude News at a Glance. Please do join for questions and answers. Have a nice day. Thank you.